Let's be honest. The only reason we don't like when somebody judges somebody's body is when they're saying something negative.
100%.
Because if they're telling you how fly you look and how beautiful you are, you got a fat ass. Now you got nice breasts. Mm. Like I, in the morning, these young ladies, Taylor, Sim, they walk in. Oh, look at fat. Oh, you got a fat ass. Fat ass. I'm like, they do that. So it's
girls though.
But you're still judging each other's bodies.
No, you know what? This is not fair because Sim and. What's the other girl's name?
Michaela.
Sim and Michaela both like pussy.
No, not Sim.
Oh, so Michaela. My bad.
Label me a lesbian.
My bad, Sim. But Michaela likes pussy. So if Michaela's like, you got fat ass, she means it.
Ooh.
That's sexual harassment. Ooh. That's sexual harassment. Because if you would sexualize, if you sexualize someone, that's sexual harassment. It's like,
that's no, a good point.
And anything that you find sexual about someone else, don't you think that we should equate this? Anything you find sexual about someone else that you're sexually attracted can count as sexual harassment. For example, if a girl goes up to you, if a girl values financial success, mm-hmm. and she goes up to you, she goes, okay, Charlotte, I see that watch you got on. That's a nice little Rolex. You are sexually harassed in that moment because she sexualizes your financial security.
Sexually? Really?
It turns a girl on, a guy that can buy a watch like that. Financial security. Hey, there's a point here, is there not? A little bit.
Bro, I love the brilliant idiot hot take. It's why we the brilliant idiots,
that's
baby.
Why we the brilliant idiots, all right? You know what I'm saying? Whipping dicks out. Where the bucket's at? I'm trying to find one.
And if the bucket don't work, I'm going to stick my fist in it with the rollie attached
there
to it.
There we go.
That's the time we're on anyway.
Let's go. You tell me what time it is.
No, all I'm simply saying is the judging of people's bodies has been going on before us, and it's going to go on way after us.
Yes.
That's just the way it is. And I'm not saying it's a good thing. I'm not just saying it's a bad thing. It's just a thing. So to say, should a man comment on a woman's body? I don't know. I really don't have an answer. I just know that's the way things are, because women do it to men. Men do it to women. Men do it to other men. I learned from women. You know how women be saying, oh, you got a fat ass to each other, big teeth. That's why I objectify men.
So how you do it to men?
I do it all the time.
What do you say?
I killed M-Easy and Envy and
what'd you say to
Drama?
Them?
Oh, all types of shit.
Like what?
I'd be like, I told Drama's, Drama's got a beard.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I'm gonna brush your fucking beard. You know what I'm saying?
And Drama, that just seems nice. It's like a nice thing to do.
And Drama would just be like, yo, you weird, bro. It's the truth, though. I tell him, pull his fucking pants up.
Why? Because he's flirting?
I'm tired. Exactly.
Yeah.
Tired of seeing your little red box of briefs that I've been watching for the past 9 years.
Yo.
Pull your goddamn pants up, Envy.
Envy really okay? Got no ass, huh? Do some squats.
Yeah, no cheeks.
He got no cheeks.
No
Yo,
cheeks,
Envy,
bro.
Do some squats,
no
bro.
Cheeks. Long back, long beige back.
You know
long
mean?
Beige back.
How you going to bust it wide open when you got nothing to bust?
Nothing. And that's why he shows it off so much. He like to do push-ups. You know what I'm saying? With his pants
come
sagging.
On, bro.
He'll lift his shirt up a little bit so all his ass is out.
Come on,
you know what
bro.
I mean?
We're
and then wonder
men.
Why a motherfucker saying shit.
That's it.
What are you wearing, Envy?
What are you
why
wearing?
Why would you wear that why if you don't want me to say something?
Thank you.
Y'all missing the real point of it all.
What's the point?
What's the point?
Because, like, for me, Sam and Michaela to do that, we're all fine.
See, that's what's wrong with y'all. We ain't talking about y'all. We talking about dicks over here
right
now. Yeah, yo. See, why don't you even jump into this conversation?
Real talk,
man. We over
here
having a nice gay moment, and here you come wanting to add some goddamn women to the mix.
This dick talk,
keep
the pussy
fist
talk.
Dick talk.
Dick segment. Let's go.
Exactly.
Let's go. Stick to that
shit. Come on now.
Fuck out of here.
But y'all are friends, too, though. You're not going to do it to a random guy on the street.
Oh, says who? See, I won't walk up to some random guy in the street.
Do you
tell
me
you got fat ass.
Are you saying you need me to push this culture forward? Are you telling me I need to take this to the streets, Taylor? Is that what you're telling me? If you want me to objectify these guys for real?
Real talk.
You want them to feel the pain that you felt your whole entire life?
Let's go.
You want me to go out there with these Timbs and these jeans on and start catcalling motherfuckers? If I wasn't a married man, I'd take you up on your
black man don't cheat. Black okay. man don't cheat. You know what I'm saying?
I read that in a book a long time ago, though, From Niggas to Gods, man.
What?
That was the name of the book, From Niggas to Gods by Akil. And he said, he was talking about how guys objectify women and catcall women and comment on women. And he was like, what if fucking Mike Tyson was walking the streets doing that shit to dude, slapping him on the ass, catcalling, what would you do?
Hey, you got it, Mike.
You guys never had gay guys do that to you?
Yeah, but not as crazy. They just they usually lock in with some eye contact.
That's all.
And then they try to see where you're at.
Yeah,
this is what gay guys do. They'd be like this. They'd be like. Then they wait for you to do something back to let them know it's okay.
Not the gay guys. They'd be like, Sharla, I know you just ain't going to walk by here with that little fat ass Sharla and not come speak to me.
Wait, what gay guys do you know that talk like that? I need to meet these gay guys. You even put his hand on his hip like a little teapot. Did you see that? Please tell me we got that shit. I'm Sharla. I'm Sharla. I see you got rips in your jeans.
Yo, a gay teapot would be funny as hell. I'm
is there a
teapot short and stout?
Where is your dick?
Here is my mouth. Oh my God, man.
See what a little structure does?
Little structure,
show?
Baby.
Little structure.
That's a little
bro.
Format.
Listen to Uncle Sharla.
That's
he knows the game.
This little is formatted.
He knows
that's
the game.
We just need a little format. Everything else will flow. We just need a little format. All right, let's take a break for a second.